Brethren, this is Pastor Peter. You know, when God created man, when he made the world, the Bible said the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the surface of the earth, and God said, let there be. And there was a time came, God said, let us make man in our own image and likeness. And when he created man, he gave man a mandate not to eat the fruit that is in the middle of the garden. But Eve was deceived by the devil, by the enemy, and he ate and gave to the husband, Adam, and both of them ate together. And their eyes were open, and therefore they were separated from God. And because of that separation, God had to kill an animal to cover their sin, because they were using fig leaves to cover their sins. But right now, God used an animal. And then this was done all this while when God initiated the same thing in Egypt. And then from that, God had been doing that, and the people had been doing that until Jesus Christ came. Jesus Christ became the sacrifice that is needed for our sins. For those who don't know Christ, that's what Jesus did. His blood become the sacrifice. Because of his blood, we can stand before God. Because of his blood, we are forgiven. That blood is what cleansed us. That's why the Bible says that if we confess our sin in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, that he is faithful and just to forgive us from all unrighteousness, and his blood cleanses us from all sins. Through his blood, we have redemption. Through his blood, we have hope. Through his blood, that blood is what brought us together to God, because of the blood of Jesus Christ. And that blood is what made it possible for us to call ourselves children of God. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. For it is written in the word of God, Romans chapter 6, verse 23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And the eternal life is only obtained through Christ Jesus, because of the blood of Jesus Christ. That is why we are here. And it says again, Romans chapter 3, verse 23, it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But because of that blood, if you look at verse 24, it says, because of the price that Christ paid. I'll read it clearly so you can understand what we are trying to put. Romans chapter 3, verse 24. Look at what it says. It says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ. That redemption is what we are talking about. The redemption comes through the blood of Jesus Christ. Through the redemption that comes through the blood of Jesus. Look at verse 25. When God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood to declare his righteousness for the remission of sin that are passed through the forbearance of God, which means without blood of Jesus Christ, there is no hope. So I want to tell all of us today, the message of Good Friday. They call it Good Friday because it's a good day. Like some religious activities, we go and wear clothes and then wear black and they say, oh, we want to mourn. Jesus is not dead any longer. He died more than 2,000 years ago and he resurrected. He's no more hanging on the tree. He's sitting in the right hand of God in heaven. And therefore, Good Friday is meant, it's called Good Friday because that was the day the sins of the world were paid for. The sins that me and you committed was paid for. That was the day our healing was paid for. That was the day our redemption was bought. Christ bought our redemption. Because for God to be justified, somebody must die. He said, whom shall I send? And Jesus said, send me. And that's why he came, to die for us, to carry our sin, to carry the burden that we have. And because he carried those burdens, we together, all of us together, have been able to be redeemed by that same blood of Jesus Christ. And he died, and he resurrected on the third day to give us life. And today, we are children of the light. We are his children. and enjoy this day. May the Lord God bless this little word that I've given. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.